Hello, let's start with the short introduction for this technology group, so we can get started later on to the breaking rooms. So it's great to be together for this live session of the WPC Leadership Forum, and we are going to present the work done within the WPC Technology Working Group. Our group goal it was to explore existing technology that could improve the lives of people living with Parkinson's and to promote some innovative actions. Our work over the past year included internally discussions and researchers, as well as presentation from technology groups with devices or systems for people with Parkinson's. The high level summary of this work is that despite of the numerous benefits that technology can offer to people with Parkinson's, there is not a centralized location that catalogs existing technologies, devices, and services, and there is no consensus on which of them work the best. So as a result, people living with Parkinson's do not know about the existing potential options or how to access them. Researchers and companies looking for developing innovative initiative, the technology may even duplicate efforts for producing the devices, services that already existing on the market. And opportunities for collaboration to build upon or improve existing technologies may be missed due to the lack of awareness of other technology efforts. This brings us to where we are today. And to continue, we need to learn more about a few items through a survey process that we're going to put in place in the future. We look forward to receive feedback from you during the breakout groups to help guide our efforts. We are envisioning conducting two surveys. The first one is directed to the ASI situation, the state of art. So we need to know to ask to the WPC partner which kind of application or services are they using based on the tech or communication solution. Identify and reach tech and telco companies which products portfolio is related to Parkinson's. And then we need to analyze how we should be the future situation we'd want to have and identify a group of experts for this needs definition task force, select which population we want to focus on and which technologies provides the most benefit to people with Parkinson's. A specific outcome that we expect from this process include creating a catalog of the existing technologies that people and organizations can globally access. This would be a standing resource and would require some level of maintenance, of course. Based on the identified needs from the WPC Task Force group, we can examine available technology resources and make a recommendation to the WPC for a potential partnership. This partnership could help develop or increase the access to a specific technology for unserved population. This is the survey that we have want to your help to build on. And the main question would be for the survey one, what items should be included in the survey? What we are thinking of needs, desires, use, and gaps? What does the group perceive as a barrier to people completing the surveys? And who are the end user who can complete the surveys? The second one will be targeted to technology providers because we want to know what are the standard questions that we should ask to them. And if there are any organization out that they have created or collated a list of information about what's out there, it's going to be very important for us. And if there is any content about partnership with organization that we should think about when going through this process. And finally, how do we reach the people who have the technology? We are waiting after the breaking room session for a wrap up where we can share all the comments that you provided during the session and to find your conclusion.
Hi everyone, welcome back from your table sessions or your breakout sessions. I'm here to welcome you as the hosts from this working group are making their way back from the breakout rooms onto the virtual stage. And I had the chance to actually sit in a couple of the breakout rooms. And I just think the topic of technology and Parkinson's, there's so many opportunities for us to continue exploring this topic. And it was so interesting, the roundtable group that I was sitting with, you know, we touched on things like how user-friendly is the technology that we're talking about, and is it actually meaningful and useful to the physicians and clinicians that are seeing the person, and how do we ensure that? And then also looking at technology through a cultural lens, and if can you really create a one-stop shop app or device if it's not culturally sensitive, and how do we then layer in that that as well. And I can see that the participants are back on the stage, so I'm going to hand over to the technology working group, and Veronica's up on the stage next. So I'm going to pass the baton off to Veronica and enjoy the rest of this session.
Thank you, Eli. So yeah, thanks for joining us back on the main stage today. That was a really interesting discussion we had in my breakout group, and I'm assuming that everyone else has had loads of really good feedback, which is so important for our group. We were really looking forward to hearing from everybody to make sure that we're on track and the next steps that we take are really in line with what the community feels. And then we're going to hear back from some of our facilitators from the breakout groups just to wrap up and see what the general feedback was. So Rebecca, if I go to you first, can you give us a bit of an update of what was said in your group?
Yes, so we talked a lot about everything sort of connected together. So we talked a lot about access to technology and ensuring that we don't make assumptions as to who has access to technology and who doesn't, because you could assume somebody doesn't have access to something, or that they do have access and they don't. And so making sure that whatever we do and whatever questions that we are asking, that we have that in mind, but also data security and privacy, and making sure that we understand that whatever technology companies that we work with, that we are thinking about motivation and what that motivation might be, and that they have the right systems in place for that data security. And then finally, even just in terms of like who are, I know I'm kind of going all over the place, but who the initial survey is for, we thought that having a survey for, you know, not just organizations, but also the end users being the people with Parkinson's and people surrounding people with Parkinson's and still be the people using that. But also keeping those surveys pretty short and keeping them easy to understand, not getting too technical. I don't know if that happened in the rest of your groups, those sort of comments, but for the technology companies that we do survey to make sure that maybe they're a little bit more in depth and a little longer to really understand what they are working on.
Yeah, thanks, Rebecca. And yeah, definitely the language, I'm sure, was a common theme, but not only the actual language, but the technical language as well was a really good comment. So looking at, you know, different languages, but then what's the type of tech language that we're using, and are people actually going to understand that, being just really user-friendly, really clear with what it means? Because yeah, like we've said very often, if people don't know what's out there, they can't say they would like it. So it's how do we kind of word the questions in a way that gives people the opportunity to really explain what they need, but in really clear language. So yeah, thanks, Rebecca. Okay, so let me just have a look. We'll go to Cynthia. I'm just going to keeping an eye on the chat. Cynthia, can you tell us a little bit about your breakout group and what were the key points?
Absolutely. Thank you. One of the things I think the group discussion validated is that it's overwhelming. There's so much technology out there. Where do you even begin, and how do you piece this all together? But we'll start, and that's exciting. One of the things I think that is the goal of our group is gathering information that so many people know and bringing it together. And that just happened in real time in our group. I think we've recruited everybody to join our working group. And I see in the chat, you know, already people are dropping in articles and links. Did you know this was out there? Did you know this was out there? And that's exactly the magic we want to have happen. A couple interesting conversations that we had. One was, once we gather this information and if we have it someplace available, how do we categorize that? You know, when people come to something, what's the best way? Is it by the user? I'm a clinician, I'm a researcher, I'm a person with Parkinson's disease, or is it by the device? These are wearables, these are technology, telehealth platforms. And so that was a consideration for us to think about as we move forward. The other thing that was very interesting was how many technologies may be out there that aren't specific for Parkinson's disease, but could be so valuable for people. And how do we access those technologies and then maybe work with those companies to slightly tweak them in a way and a manner that could be valuable? A nice comment about really empowering the person with Parkinson's to know their own needs and then be able to search for something that's specific to them. And so how do we make that information accessible and usable for them? And let's see, what were other key points? It was just such a lively discussion, which I'm sure many of you had. One other point, and then I'll turn it back over, was, and I'm sure this came up in all groups, how this past year, albeit a terrible pandemic, opened all of our eyes and got us all more into technology and the ability to utilize that. And from the group up in BC, Jean talked about how they had 50 support groups and were able to get at least 35 of them online. And so we're able to continue those connections. But then, of course, what about the 15 left behind? And how do we get technology to those who maybe are a little resistant or a little naive or don't have access to that? So there was much more, but those were some of the highlights. So Veronica, I'll send it back to you.
Yeah, perfect. And I'll come back to some questions and comments from the chat, but I just wanted to also reiterate that if anybody wants to join our working group, then we would be happy to have you on board, whether you're a tech expert or just have an interest in the subject and found, you know, from what we're saying today, that actually you could contribute. We would be happy to have more people on board for this big project that we have lined up. So just pop it in the chat if you wanted to join our group, or you can contact us after as well. We'd be definitely happy to hear from you. I'm just going to take a couple of the comments from the chat. So we definitely have, somebody has mentioned, you know, the MDS technology working group that I believe we have mentioned in our group that we know that exists. So yeah, so the MDS tech working group, and we also had somebody mentioned the Digital Parkinson's UK group. So if anybody knows of any other groups that are already cataloging or looking at digital technology for Parkinson's disease, then yeah, let us know, because obviously we don't want to reinvent the wheel from scratch, and we can just get the data from other places and see what kind of work they're doing and maybe work together. So that's really good. And also in our group, another place to look for tech was mentioned a couple of times is universities, and how they are a really good source of information to go and get information of what's maybe already out there or things that they are developing themselves. So we have a question about how can we maximize the survey participation, and will the data be shared with participants so they can continue to give feedback? Cynthia, would you like to take that?
Absolutely. What I've learned over these few days of the forum is a lot of our working groups want to learn more information. And so surveys certainly have come out of that. And I think that point for all of our groups will be critical. How do we get maximum distribution and maximum uptake and people to actually take the surveys? So things about keeping them simple, I think, like Rebecca mentioned, writing in a language that can be shared. And so that'll be something I think this entire forum and the WPC, hopefully we can all work together for that. And my assumption is absolutely information will be shared. I mean, that's what this is all about, bringing information together, putting it in a digestible way. That'll be some of the job of our working group, but then getting that out there and sharing that with the world. It is the point and the purpose, I think, of all of the work that we are doing.
Yeah, definitely. Great stuff. And we had a comment in our group about what makes an app, what makes an app want you to use it, right? So you download an app, you start to use it, and then after a week, you're like, I'm not happy or, you know, something's just not right. So maybe you could just pop some ideas in the chat in general, you know, what makes an app more user-friendly or make you want to actually engage with it and keep on using it? So we had somebody also pop in the chat already, something about gamification and making it kind of like a reward system on there that might engage you more to keep using it. So yeah, it'd be interesting to know from the public today on, you know, what makes you want to keep using that app. And it could be anything. And we'll take that on board. Yeah, looking at the existing tool that has an update that can be repurposed. Yep, as Cynthia said, that's a really good way of doing it, isn't it? Rather than starting from scratch. Thank you to everyone that said they want to join our group. That's excellent. And yep, I need to educate the medical community on telemedicine if they don't do this in their region. Yeah, so definitely, yeah, a really, really important point. I don't know, Rebecca, if you wanted to elaborate a little bit on that.
Yeah, actually, that was one of the things that we also were sort of discussing in our group, was just about, you know, telemedicine is something that we've talked a lot about and that our group talked a lot about in terms of access. And especially this last year, we saw a huge uptick in the use of telemedicine. And we do know that telemedicine is a great option for people with Parkinson's. And so I definitely think that will be something that we will want to continue discussing, but also not, you know, about that education and how do we educate or reach our medical community. And actually, one of the suggestions was that as a part of our survey, we also include to technology providers is that we potentially include the medical community in that, or doctors, or either that and in the first survey, because they are already using some of them technology and or telemedicine potentially, and maybe they have some ideas as to how we can educate their peers. I think that's so. We'll definitely a conversation to continue having, and definitely a. As Veronica said, we have seen a lot of you who are interested in maybe joining our group. So hopefully you can come with some of those ideas, because we definitely welcome fresh perspectives.
Thank you. Yeah, absolutely. And I did see a comment in there. I did mention it in our group about the sort of the gamification of a software or exercise program. And there was a study by Bas Bloom that was trying to encourage people to do, I think it was a cycling exercise, a home kind of bicycle exercise, but they could get rewards. I'm not sure if it was even money that they got, but this was for the study, obviously. But it did keep people really engaged and want to do their exercise, and then the researchers could get the outcome based on that. So that's a really great way. So again, thank you for everyone that's asking to join our group and sending us these really great links. I'm sorry we didn't get Malcolm back on. We had some sound issues, and I think we're just coming up to our time, so unless Cynthia or Rebecca have any other comments that you wanted to add.
Just thank you, everyone. This is so exciting. Trust me, it's a real boost of energy for our group, and we're so excited for all the recruits and all the links and all the information. So I just say thank you.
Yes, I echo that. Thank you all so much for joining us today. This has been awesome. I know in our group, Joanne was with me. She's on our working group, and she was also equally excited. So hopefully, Joanne, it's okay if I speak for you as well, and for the rest of our group. But we are just so excited for just everything that you all brought today.
Excellent. So yeah, thank you to everyone who joined us today, and thank you to the rest of the working technology group that's behind the scenes helping us out as well. So thank you, everybody. Really great session. Take care, everyone. Thank you.